Match game 74, production number 0272, take one. Get ready to match the stars. Orson Bean. Brett Somers. Charles Nelson Reilly. Dr. Joyce Brothers. Richard Dawson. And Betty White. As we play the star-studded big money match game 74. And now, the star of Match Game 74, Gene Rayburn!
Hello there. Thank you, Johnny Olson. Thank you, friends, for joining us here at Match Game 74. We're going to have a whole peck of fun today because all the ding-a-lings are gathered here today. How? Hey, listen, you just moved to California. Is it okay?
Yes, I love it. We're
terrific.
Happy as clams.
It's a great place. Your wife, Caroline, likes it?
Yeah. She loves it. The four kids love it. Even the cat loves it.
Okay.
Mice the size of this. We import them from Texas.
Oh, everything's healthy out here.
Yes.
Fruits and vegetables, they grow like crazy. That's one thing you got to say about California. The fruits and vegetables are terrific. I say that all the time.
Particularly the fruits, dear.
What do you say? We say hello to our two players, Terry Montgomery and Jan Shaw. Terry's the current champion. He's got $600 to his credit. He's won one game.
Yeah.
And he's being challenged by Jan. She's had her first-round question, and she scored two matches. And we have a first-round question for you, and you will get that in a moment or so. Are you ready for it?
I'm ready.
Okay. Ready. Now, we got a little business here we want to do, and then you come right back. Yes, we're all ready here, and I'll push a button here and reveal our other first-round question for Terry. This is for you, Terry.
Okay.
Let me see what it says here.
Yes.
They just put a vicious watchdog in front of the White House.
Ooh.
He's trained to keep blank out. Let me do that one more time there. I don't understand. They just put a vicious watchdog in front of the White House. He's trained to keep blank out. Did you hear all that?
I heard.
All right. Okay. Vicious watchdog in front of the White House. He's trained to keep blank out.
Who's answering this?
Anybody this is for Terry.
Andy.
Terry's question. It's his first round question.
Hi, Terry.
You look very chic today, my dear.
Oh, thank you, my darling.
Like my little number?
Yes. You really went California all the way.
J.C. Penney.
You used to wear shirts and ties back east.
Always, yes.
But now you've...
Now you're in the land
you
of
cut
the...
your hair? What'd you cut your hair for?
I don't know. 5 cents.
Can you shave your beard off?
Yeah, everything.
Is everybody ready?
Did you say bomb, Betty?
Except Charles, of course. All right, now Charles is ready. And we'll call on Terry. They just put a vicious watchdog in front of the White House. He's trained to keep blank out.
Democrats?
Democrats. The audience is groaning and making funny sounds there. We'll find out why in a moment or so. Orson, may we see your answer?
Yeah, I guess Democrats is the answer, but I figured Nixon would really rather keep reporters out.
Yeah. Okay. Brett?
The audience was groaning, right?
Yep.
And making a lot of funny sounds?
Right, at Democrats.
Well, it just shows you how much they know. Democrats, my guy.
Okay.
All right.
I think it's the boss. It smartened me up.
Oh, it sure did.
Democrats.
There it is. Craft is moving on a tie score. Joyce, you can untie the score.
I can't. I said tapes because I figured they were sorry they let them in the first place.
I see. Keep the
tapes. I don't think she's so smart for a doctor.
She's smart for a dizzy blonde, though.
May I ask a question before
you may ask
I answer?
A question, yes.
What is Charles smoking in that pipe?
The tapes.
The tapes.
The press.
The press, she said. What are you? Don't answer. No commercials there.
A rugged guy's tobacco.
A rugged guy?
Well, you should give it back to him.
Okay. So, two to two, the score.
We got the hint nationwide, Miss White.
Which he borrowed from Liberace.
Now, is it all right if I go on?
Go right ahead.
Thank you very much.
Where are you going?
I'll push this button here and reveal our second and final round questions. Ask Jan to make a selection.
B, please.
B, score is tied 2-2. Last time you matched Betty and Orson, the two of you will not play. Everyone else will. Tough Tony said, "My gang is so tough, we even steal a blank from moving cars." That's how tough they are.
How tough are they?
steal the blank from moving cars.
Oh.
Oh, I've got a good answer for that. I'm sorry I'm not
playing. Oh, me too. I have a terrific answer,
yeah,
and you're going to love my
answer.
You're going to go crazy and mad with delight.
All right. Here we go, Jan. Tough Tony said my gang is so tough we even steal the blank from moving cars.
Hubcaps?
Hubcaps.
Hubcaps.
Correct. Hubcaps. What's she say?
I'm an intellectual and I'm impartial. So I go to swing from side to side. I said hubcaps.
Atta girl. Okay. Hubcaps.
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 Four hubcaps.
Four hubcaps so far. That's eight, actually, if it's two cars. What do you say?
I'm really tough. Wheels.
Wheels? Oh, that's... Oh, boy. That is really difficult.
I said earlier about the doctor.
Doctor. You're right.
You Richard? Take two hubcaps and call me in the morning.
Hubcap.
Hubcap. That's five for Jan. And
that's it.
Okay. All right. Now, Terry, you've got match three to stay in the game. Four, however, will it with another game for you. We'll find out if that happens or not. But first, we got to do a little business with you, and this is it. All right. Here we go with our second and final round. And, Terry, remember, you've got a match three to stay in the game. Four will win another game. Dumb Dora is so dumb.
How dumb is she?
She says wheels.
No, I'm glad you asked. She's so dumb that to save time in the morning, she blanks before she goes to sleep. That's how dumb she is. Dumb Dora is so dumb that to save time in the morning, she blanks before she goes to sleep.
I get it, and I'm not... Harry, I can't help you, darling. I get it, but I can't help you.
Charles, you're not playing.
I know. I'm doing some Christmas cards.
Oh, I see. Brett and Charles matched last time, so they do not participate. Okay. Now, we're all set, and we call on Terry. Dumb Dora is so dumb, but to save time in the morning, she blanks before she goes to sleep.
Dresses?
Dresses before she goes to sleep. The audience is yaying, and I suspect from the look on your face, they're going to lynch you.
Wouldn't help. Dora's a topless waitress. Dora eats breakfast before she goes to sleep to save time.
She had dresses.
You had dresses.
I've been playing.
All
this
right.
Crowd could get very surly.
Dresses is the answer he's looking for. Let's see what Joyce has.
Let's shape up this time.
I'm afraid of Brett.
Dresses, because you're afraid of Brett. All right, Richard, he's got to match everybody remaining. That includes you and Miss White over there.
Yeah, well, I'll take the fall here.
Please, please.
The only way I can get out is if I've written eat dresses. She eats breakfast before she goes.
She eats breakfast? What do you have? Eats breakfast. That seems to be the answer. Jan Shaw, the winner. Come on down.
We want to shake hands with you and congratulate you. I know you're excited, but step over here.
And it is exciting to win, isn't it?
Yeah.
All right, you stand by for a moment or so, Jan, while we say goodbye to Terry, who's going to leave here with $600,
right,
together with our thanks and best wishes for being here. I hope you enjoyed it.
It'll be well spent. Thank you.
Now, this rotating thing here means you're going to have a go at some big money, over $5,000 to be specific. Are you ready for it?
Oh, I don't know. I think I'm ready for the doctor, but I'll try.
Oh, really? Yeah. Dr. Brothers, could you bring your stethoscope there? I'll, no, I guess I won't. We polled a recent studio audience, Jan, and we got their best response to this. Blank in Paris. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500, if you match it. Then if you match the next one, you get $250. And if you match a bottom one, you get $100. Which ones would you like a little help from?
Joyce.
Springtime in Paris.
Springtime in Paris. No, they say no.
Richard?
An American in Paris.
American in Paris.
Oh, my. Betty?
Evening in Paris.
Oh! Evening in Paris.
And Betty is still wearing Evening in Paris.
Well, I'm
okay.
Not wearing Jockey Club. Well, I
you smell like you're wearing Jockey Club.
That's enough out of that, though. Now, you've got Springtime in Paris, and American in Paris, and Evening in Paris. You may choose one of those or think up one of your own. But you're on your own right now, and we call for an answer.
Evening in Paris.
Evening in Paris. Yeah. Okay. That's what you're looking for. Evening in Paris, huh? All right, let's go. What the heck? You got the $100. That's what the one she hopes will be up there. And we'll find out if it's up there. And if so, where?
April.
As soon as I get my teeth back in place here. Let's see the $100 response. Last Tango in Paris.
I hated that movie.
You hated that movie. Evening in Paris is what she wants. Let's see if it's under the $250 response. Evening in Paris it is. Congratulations.
April. Shame on you.
Orson and Brett say that April in Paris is the one under the $500. Do you agree with that? Well, we'll find out all together right now what's under the $500 response. April in Paris it is.
April in Paris.
Yes, indeed.
April in Paris.
Jen. You've got 250. You play for 10 times that amount or $2,500 to collect. Remember, you got to match one celebrity, and it's time to choose one now.
Betty White.
Okay, Betty, you get ready to write. Jan will face me. Here's the $2,500 question. Blank sand. S-A-N-D. Blank sand. Okay, she's finished. Now, we need an answer from you that you think will match Betty White. What do you say to that? Blank sand.
Oh, gee, blank sand.
I said that. You have to say something else. Blank sand.
Play in the sand.
Play in the sand. All right, that's your answer. That's what you think will match Betty White. Betty, for $2,500, may we see your answer now?
Quicksand.
Quicksand.
I'm sorry.
Quicksand. Okay, well, Jan, you're up to $350, and you will be meeting another player later, but first we've got to do this for America. Here you go.
Terrific.
Hello there. Listen, what are we doing? Oh, we're going to play another game. You ready, Jan? All right, then let's welcome our new player. Here is Lorraine Brown. How are you, Lorraine? Where are you from?
From Santa Monica.
Santa Monica.
I'm married to a wonderful man, and we have two beautiful little boys.
I'll bet you do. Okay, you ready to have a go at this?
Yes.
Good luck to you,
Thank
Lorraine.
You.
Push this button, ask you to make a selection.
B, please.
B. All right, new game, folks. You ready? It says here,
yes.
Walter fell asleep and dreamed he was a giant ice cream sundae. When he woke up, his wife was covering him with blank. Walter fell asleep. He dreamed he was a giant ice cream sundae. When he woke up, his wife was covering him with blank. How are you, Mike? Glad you dropped by. Everything okay? Who's minding the store if you're here in the studio? All right.
I'm ready. Charles isn't even awake yet.
Charles?
Honey, we've got to wake up. This is a game. We do this every week. We come, we arrive at the studio, they put our makeup on.
His lips are moving, so his brain must be working.
I doubt that. Just because his lips are moving does not mean that his brain is working.
Why?
It's involuntary action on his part.
I see. He's written something. There he is.
He's chewing some sesame seeds, that's all.
All right.
He doesn't have to without.
Now, Lorraine, Walter fell asleep and dreamed he was a giant ice cream sundae. When he woke up, his wife was covering him with...
Whipped cream.
Whipped cream. The audience is applauding whipped cream, Orson. What say you to that, sir?
I guess it's all a matter of taste. Walter's wife was covering him with fudge sauce.
Oh, fudge sauce. That makes my mouth water.
What are these strange people doing in there?
I don't know.
Going to my place later.
Never, what I thought they all came to your office. Well, it was a question of whipped cream.
Yeah.
Or something else.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, with my, well, nuts.
Okay. All right. That's way to make a sundae. Charles?
Following right on the heels of Last Tango in Paris, whipped cream.
All right. What do you say? You
want to
go home?
Cold feet. That would make you dream like that.
Well, I guess my enunciation must have been wrong.
Let's
Let's mug her in the parking lot.
Let's mug her. Let's get her.
Well, let's his wife is covering him with... You say cold food. Yeah. Yeah, I'd like to hear that.
Walter fell asleep and dreamed he was a giant ice cream sundae. Uh-huh. When he woke up, his wife was covering him with...
Cold feet. That would start you dreaming of an ice cream sundae.
Yes, that's an excellent. Okay. That's actually the best answer,
Doctor.
I'd like to know where she got her degree.
All these people with whipped cream.
I think another 1,000 hours on the couch and you'll be all right.
She'll be ready to solo.
Yes.
You actually charge people for advice, don't you?
No, I pay them.
Oh, well, that's all right.
All right, Richard, let's see yours.
Well, I'm very gentle.
Yep.
I think it's very cruel to whip cream. I don't mind kicking it again, but hot fudge.
Hot fudge.
Yes. Lovely. Right between your pillows.
Yes. What did you say?
It does beat parsley. I said whipped cream.
Good. Whipped cream. So that's two for you. Now let's see what we've got for you, Jan. This is your first round question. Day 11 said...
Hi, Trigger.
This Thanksgiving, we're not going to have a turkey.
Oh.
I'm going to stuff my blank instead. Day 11 said, this Thanksgiving, we're not having a turkey. I'm going to stuff my blank instead. I'm going to stuff my blank instead. You like this program? Richard, you having the best time today, I can tell.
I am.
Okay, Orson Brett ready, Charles ready. Richard, you're the last one.
I'm writing it in Gaelic.
You know, this has never happened before. You're the last one.
It did. It happened once before.
I had to wait 10 minutes to see the doctor.
Okay, Jan. Day 11 said, this Thanksgiving, we're not going to have a turkey. I'm going to stuff my blank instead.
Horse,
she said. Horse is what she said. What do you say?
Cheval stuffé, horse.
Cheval stuffé, all right. There's one horse, Brett.
He speaks many tongues, and all of them badly. I said, stuff my goose.
Goose. All right, that's a traditional...
You shouldn't do that because you know it makes me cry.
Charles, what do you say? Stuffed horse.
Stuff my goose.
Horse.
Horse again.
Horse again, that's two. Now, let's see what Miss Normal has.
Warm hands.
I've been horsing around, too.
Goodness.
Congratulations, you've been cured. Only took you a couple of shows.
Now you're as much sugar as all of us.
Yeah.
Horse Trigger.
That's it. There's another one for you. Okay. What do you say, Betty White?
I think you're all sick. That's a...
They did stuff their horse, you know.
Animal lover.
They did.
Oh, you did. But they didn't do it for Thanksgiving.
No,
I think they did it for Veterans Day.
Well, that could be. I never can remember whether it's cooked my goose or... I never can remember
the
goose.
There it is. All right, yeah. She says goose, and that's four for you and
Thank
two
you
for you. Now we go to round two, right? Let's see what we do here. Lorraine, make a selection.
A, please.
A. Now, last time you matched Betty and Charles, the two of you lay out, the rest of you respond to this. George said,
yeah.
Boy, is Ted's wife strange looking. When I first saw her, I thought she was his blank. Boy, is Ted's wife strange looking. When I first saw her, I thought she was his blank.
Oh, are you playing there?
Sure, darling, I'm waiting. Right.
Okay, here we go, Lorraine. George said, boy, is Ted's wife strange looking. When I first saw her, I thought she was his blank.
Brother.
Brother. Brother is what she says. What do you say, Orson? I thought she was his...
Thought she was his dog.
Oh, yeah. Brett, what do you say?
Oh, don't cheer him. She thought he was his boyfriend.
Boyfriend. Okay, got to match the rest here. We're getting down here to Joyce. What do you say?
Mom, I did it.
Joyce, brother. Yeah, let's hear it for Joyce. That's two in a row. Boy, is she cured.
All right, now
you've got to match Richard to stay in the game.
Brother.
Okay. Now, you've got a chance to win this game. At this moment, it's tied up, but you've got a question to go, and we'll see how that ends up. But first, we've got to do some business. Here it is. Now, It's time to call it quits for today, and we're going to stop right here. The score is 4-4. You have one question to go, and we'll say goodbye to all of our celebrated folks here. You were splendid as usual, and we thank you. Is there anything anyone would like to say before...
How much money do you make?
Help! No, you're having a good time. You're having a lot of laughs here. You gave two right answers, and what the heck?
Would you hurry up? I have a session with the doctor.
Oh, all right. This is Gene Redmond saying so long for Match Game 74, asking you to join us next time. Thank you. Goodbye.